happened in Lagos?
They fucked me. TV.
I got the peanut butter cup perfection. What did you get?
I'm gonna beat the shit out of her.
What happened?
The girl that's next to her, because she was staring right at you.
Do not let someone squeeze your baby's head. Learn about it and stay informed.
Goodbye.
Okay, first of all, why didn't anyone tell me that if you have yeah? My bad. So I forgot. I didn't think about it. I'm home alone. And I thought that someone called me and I'm home alone.
Melody.
Maybe it was my cat and she sounds like a human sometimes.
That was you, right? Right?
What the fuck?
Too scared to open my door.
Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. I told you. Come here.
The reason I had to move out of my flat. I was home alone.
Then what's your name then?
Who are you?
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 I hardly know, sir.
I hardly know, sir. Just at present.
I hardly know, sir. Just at present.
I hardly know, sir, a present.
I hardly know, sir, just a present.
At least, I know who I was when I got up this morning. But I think I must have changed several times since then.
I know who I was when I got up this morning. But I must have changed several times since then.
I know who I was when I got up this morning.
But I think I've been changed several times since then.
I've changed so many times since this morning, you see.
I do not see. Explain yourself.
Explain yourself.
Explain yourself.
I'm afraid I can't explain myself, you see, sir.
I can't explain myself, sir, because I'm not myself, you see.
I'm afraid I can't explain myself, sir, because I'm not myself, you know.
All I need is two cusses to lean, and a bad bitch just to roll up my weed. Bending through the city with the gold on my teeth. Holly in the scrape with the foes underneath.
If you want ye old back blown in the Victorian era, then all you had to do was look a fucking state. And the rich would do a little wee wee in their pants every time they saw someone with tuberculosis, because this whole deathly pale look was really in. Tuberculosis was known as consumption and it killed over 4 million people in the Victorian era. And in the cities where it's cramped and it stinks of unwashed arse, it was doing the rounds. So before they knew much about germs, it was this mysterious romantic disease and they were proper buzzing their tits off when they'd cough blood into a handkerchief. And when you've got bugger all else to do all day, the rich would apply lead and arsenic to their face to make them seem paler. They'd chew on arsenic wafers to make their eyes brighter and sickly. Imagine wanting a shag so bad you end up getting tuberculosis and looking like the fucking corpse bride. And then by the early 1800s they are off. We look a bit like mingers, so we're probably going to stop that now. And then there was a few health campaigns. They thought women's skirts spread diseases, so you've got the maid here like brushing up the germs and creating clouds of germs infecting the children. They also thought disease was spread through mustaches because they didn't clean their razors properly. When germ theory caught on and they realised that coughing spread diseases, they put signs up like this, being like, we're not going to spit anymore. Don't do that, because it's dead bad.
Well then, Cheshire Puss, would you tell me, please, which way I ought to go from here?
That depends a good deal on where you want to get to.
That depends a good deal where you want to go.
That depends on where you want to get to.
That depends on where you want to get to.
That depends on the deal on where you want to get to.
That depends a good deal on where you want to get to.
I really don't mind where.
Then it doesn't matter which way you walk.
Then it doesn't matter which way you go.
Then it doesn't matter which way you go.
Then it really doesn't matter which way you go.
Then it doesn't matter which way you go.
So long as I get somewhere.
Oh, you're sure to do that. If you only walk long enough.
Ow! What are you doing? You little rascal. What are you, some kind of piranha? Yeah. What are you doing? Ow. You're just reckless.
Hello.
Hello,
nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
What is that?
Hi. Hi. How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Yo. That's freaky, man.
Why?
I swear I just saw something, like, on the background, on your left side. Nah, man, I'm sorry, this is too freaky.
Dude, what? Wait.
Whoa. What's this?
Why? What is that?
What the f***?
What?
Hello.
Hi.
What's your name?
Aaron.
Aaron?
Mm-hmm. Bro, what? No, I'm done with this shit.
Thank you.
tiene problemas. Idealmente no vale la pena, don't worry. Be happy.
Saw his star in the east, and we have come.
I mean, it's an Uber. It's. Can you drive away?
What? I need to call the police. I can't.
You. You need a ride?
I'm fucking pissed off.
All right.
If I wanted a ride, my thumb would be like that.
Look, that fool's scoping. Look, he's scoping. Look, he's looking. He looking like, who should I get next? Who you gonna get next, bruh? Look at it. Look at it.
Look at her.
Look at her. Damn, look at her. Damn. Damn.
They don't know what they doing.
They don't know what they doing. Hey, they don't know what they doing. Hey. Damn, they don't know what they're doing.
So it's about, I'm not really exactly sure what time it is, but my wife is on the phone because this right here is going on. Yeah. You need to. So this is still happening. So now we got some cops rolling up here. Is this shit right here? That's some wild business. Anyway, see you long, motherfucker. They need to come on around here. This is what I'm talking about. This is crazy business right here. I won't let my dog, but. Oh, shit. This right here is the wildest business I've ever seen in a long ass time. What time is it?
In the name.
They know where anybody. No. So this is still happening. I'm being rebuked in the name of Jesus. Yo, I'm not sure what happened to this lady. But I'm not sure what happened to this lady. Something got to happen. My dog is over here bugging out. This is not how I wanted this.
Out of the room. Because if it is, oh shit, that is him, bro. Lock the door.
That was their room?
That's their room, bro. We stole from them, bro. We took it from them. They're outside the door. Fuck.
Dude, make sure they don't, like, come in.
The door.
Okay, okay.
Dude, those are the fuckers we stole from last night.
Fuck. Who is it?
Who is it?
What are y'all talking about, bro?
Fuck, dude. No, fuck! Go out the back! Go out the back!
Tonight the music seems so loud. I wish that we could lose this crowd. Maybe it's better this way. We hurt each other with the things we want to say.
It was somebody black, boy. He'll be locked up. He alive?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Think so.
Maybe
dead.
Maybe
you'll die.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, okay.
Give me a fucking straw, man. A straw. Please.
There's
give
a park. There's children there.
Give a fuck again.
You can't smoke fentanyl
can
next
smoke
to the park.
I want to.
There's children playing. There's
and
children playing.
Please don't lean.
I won't touch it.
This is really dangerous. Don't lean.
Right, I promise.
All right.
If you need to start the lift, big red button.
Okay, that starts everything.
Fucking.
Dude, how far are we going? Dude, get on the button. Get on the button right now.
Hold
We're
on.
Getting close.
Nah, no, let's push it, bro. Oh, stop. That's safe. Safe, Dan. Oh, my gosh.
You got controls?
I have controls. Okay, I'm going to call him now.
That was scary.
There is.
Yeah.
The Mission Impossible.
Brayden, what is this?
Skibbity! Thank Jesus you found him. He's the only real friend I have left.
Why is it sticky?
I'm gonna plead the fifth on that, Mr. Belding.
And what's this hole in the bottom?
Behold, the skibussy. Do not look directly into it, Mr. Belding. I warn you, you could be sent to the brain rot multiverse and be stuck forever. Mr. Belding, Mr. Belding, Mr. Belding. Welcome to the Brain Rot Multiverse, where you can edge for eternity, and everyone mews and looks matches. In the solemn words of Rosa Parks, I believe we are here on this earth to live, goon, and do what we can to make this world a better place for all people to enjoy, Skibbity. Come back to me, Mr. Belding. It is not yet your time for your brain to rot away in the multiverse. Your job is not done here on this earth. Find your way back to me and finish the job you started.
Get the water.
Dasani?
Yeah?
No, I don't drink Dasani, honey.
Liquid death?
That I will take.
Okay. Alright.
She didn't want the Dasani, man.
Get off your phone! Get off your phone! No drive-bys. Hands on the wheel. Oh my god.
Later.
Ну, броски где?
I'm Ivan. I gave Omar fentanyl and took him to Target. Hey, hey, save the line.
No.
He's just watching me. How weird.
Hey, coach.
Oh, what's up, Ryan?
Here, man.
What's this? Let's see what we got here. Jenny Delcom, Lacey Como, Laura Louvier, Chrissy Thibodeau. Son, what is this?
Coach, it's a list of every girl I ever been with.
Is this for me to keep?
Yeah.
I can keep this?
Yeah.
I love offshore drilling.
One more lane. We'll always fix traffic.
I hate walkable cities, and we should not have them. America is the best place to buy a car.
I love donating too. Politicians too. Want to drill baby drill.
We should put Dollar General on offshore oil rigs. I can't stop thinking about how much I love private defense contractors.
The Saturn Ion is a compact car sold by Saturn between the 2003 and 2007 model years. It used the GM Delta platform. The Ion replaced the Saturn S series in 2002, 3, and was replaced by the new Saturn Astra in 2008. Production of the Ion ended on March 29, 2007. The Ion was the last Saturn passenger car built at the Spring Hill, Tennessee.
Howdy, partner. Come on down to Butthurst, Texas. We got it all here. A Family Dollar, a Dollar Tree, a Dollar General, our very own historic Whataburger, Texas fries.
What you gonna do? What you gonna do when the boys call? I pursue. Why break, bust it down, then sue. Call cars on my motherfuckers everyone. Why yak, bust it down, then sue.
Canadian authorities are asking for permission to destroy evidence collected during the Robert Picton case. According to the Vancouver Sun, the RCMP has asked the court for permission to destroy 14,000 pieces of evidence collected during the search of former pig farmer Robert Willie Picton's farm, where he murdered what's thought to be up to 49 people. Picton, who is eligible for parole this year, 2024, was convicted in 2007 of murdering 6 women, but more than 24 missing women files have been linked to DNA found on his farm. Many personal items like medication bottles or inhalers from victims were collected during the search, and there are also 30 additional women who vanished from Vancouver's downtown east side where he would find his victims, and those 30 women matched the time frame and the victim profile of Picton. Destroying the evidence is, of course, opposed by many people, including family members of the victims and family members of the 30 missing women who have yet to be identified or found. And, of course, people close to the case feel that this evidence is important and should be kept in storage as they could be useful in future identification efforts. This is an ongoing piece of news, and if I hear any updates, I will be back here with them.
Look at that person. She's right on the edge. Someone could just push her off and then go, ooh.
That's called an intrusive thought, and we don't say those out loud.
Don't?
That's a pretty thing.
Ooh.
Ah!
And then pull it as tight as possible so the curls come out more curly.
Yeah, and twisting is optional, but
twisting works a lot better. So it should look somewhat like that.
It could be even looser, like mine's a little bit looser, but they work the same.
Not really. Yorn.
Yeah, it's tighter.
What is Milo doing?
Milo. Milo's in the lamp.
Oh. Milo's in the lamp. My cat's in the lamp.
Look at this shit, bro. What the fuck? Dude. Bro, get off my car. Bro, who's this dude? Bro. Alright, smug it.
And you use it to pry out this lid, and the inside is just like a little shiny ball.
Plutonium.
And it looks so freaking cool. It'd be a really good piece to put on my desk or something.
There's no way that's real. It's real. He destabilized the core when it dropped. It broke, and literally he just got fried with radiation.
And he died?
No.
Yeah.
I was about to make fun of the way he talked.
I would, but then I found out he died.
And we would never.
When will we never talk about it?
Josh!
What?
You can't do that.
Tough week, Josh.
Stop!
Dude. Joshua!
It's a freaking radiation.
I think I'm in a bit of a pickle right now.
Is this freaking Chernobyl right now?
Oh no.
Then you just take him like that. And do what you want with him.
Is he hitting her in the head?
You gotta do what you gotta do.
Bullshit, that's a woman.
Huh? Well, I don't really know how to explain what they did, but...
He hit her in the head 3 or 4 times, and then the guy shot her 2 or 3 times. How dead did she need to be?
Well, in my case, it was self-defense. I don't know why he did it.
Self-defense? What are you drinking? That was a woman. The guy's twice his size. And there's Buzz out there dancing like a ballerina.
Something about Travis Kelce.
Oh. Can you
hear me? Oh my god. Hold on, wait, no one's gonna. Hold on.
Where did we lose you?
That man got shot in his face. You didn't see that?
Yeah, I saw, but what's new? He just beat the shit out of a woman and shot her 3 times, and I'm supposed to get upset over that.
Well, that's different. It was self-defense.
That woman didn't do shit. She was standing there looking like, I don't know what.
The night after WWE Universe was treated to a great Royal Rumble pay-per-view event, Mr. McMahon wanted to keep the momentum going on Raw the next night. He hosted a fan appreciation night, but during the event, McMahon admitted to the audience that he couldn't afford gifts for everyone. He revealed that he could only afford one substantial gift, which turned out to be just a picture of himself. Watching from home, Donald Trump noticed McMahon's frugality and decided to intervene via satellite. To the delight of the WWE Universe, he surprised everyone by making it rain money throughout the crowd. This made McMahon furious, so he invited Trump to appear on Raw in person, hoping to coerce him into joining his notorious Kiss My Ass Club. Trump accepted McMahon's invitation to appear in person, but didn't become a member of the club. Instead, he challenged McMahon to a one-on-one wrestling match at WrestleMania. McMahon, claiming to be injured to avoid the fight, suggested they each choose a wrestler to represent them at WrestleMania. Trump was initially displeased with this idea, but agreed under one condition. If his representative won, he would have the chance to shave McMahon's head bald. McMahon agreed, setting the stage for a hair versus hair match, soon to be dubbed the Battle of the Billionaires. When it was time to select match representatives, McMahon chose Intercontinental Champion Umaga, while Trump picked ECW Champion Bobby Lashley. This raised the stakes of the match even further, prompting the board of directors to appoint a special guest referee, Stone Cold Steve Austin. McMahon was extremely nervous, especially as Lashley dominated the opening moments of the match. However, before Lashley could secure a victory, Vince's son Shane interfered. With no referee in the ring, Shane helped Umaga assault Lashley and revealed a referee shirt. But just as Umaga was about to win, Austin intervened. This reversal allowed Lashley to spear Umaga and secure the pinfall victory. McMahon had to have his head shaved. He tried to escape, but Lashley caught him and, along with Austin and Trump, shaved McMahon's head bald.
Go back. I want to see this one. What happened to that one?
That little guy. Adult can't even clear.
That little guy?
Yeah, an adult can barely clear.
Shit. I can probably clear that.
Let's see. Tell Dad, do it. Do it.
Let Daddy
do
clear it real quick. Let me show you how to clear this.
All right, Eli, let Daddy do it. Oh, no, no, no. You're talking some smack. You got to do it now. Oh, my God. This sucks.
Here he goes. Like a masquerade.
Look at it.
Oh, my God. That's not going to heal by Monday.
Look at the lip.
Yeah, I feel the lip. Oh my, that's now?
Fuck you, you fucking cocksucking!
Yeah, I've seen a reel on Instagram. It's like how brake clean is meant to be used, and it shows just going psh, psh, on like a yeah, brake
current. Oh, like you did?
Whatever. So you wanna fight over what? You fight over what? You're asking if I can get my back, so what's up?
I don't wanna fight you.
So what's up? Well, me asking that, I'm gonna take your wig off.
They're not even paying attention to you.
Yeah, them are. Girls come with me. And zap me. Be scared. Walk away. Walk away.
Karen's on the loose again.
Tell my girls. Walk away. You scared of what? You walk away or what? You ready for it, Mom? Ready. Do a stop.
Listen, Karen. Karen, you're on the loose again. You need to stop.
Yo, let me hold your purse. Stop.
It's not even funny.
Fail what?
Nah, I'm good. I'll let
you
it.
Good? You good?
I'm
are
good.
You good?
Yes.
My girls. You fail what? You're not fighting going out. If you wait from here, I will fight you next.
东塔梦太阳升，照不出了一个毛泽东。他为人民谋幸福，呼儿海呀，他是人民大救星。
This man believes people are equal. Speak for yourself, sir. Speak for yourself.
I'm sorry. You just call me a fool.
How you want to handle this, Grandma?
Just punch him in the mouth.
I got something better.
What?
I shot the black guy.
Now see that? Oh. See that? You know everything, right?
Oh my God, I did it.
If you'd have just went ahead and punched him in the mouth, but no, you don't listen to Grandma. You done went and shot a black guy, lost him, all because you didn't punch him in the mouth while you had him.
Personal success. You think you're just going to sit around and be fat all the time and giggling? Yeah, fat and giggling. You know, it's kind of a drag to go around stupid and fat your whole life. Then take your ball home with you and do not come to class with first grade toys.
Within this tattered teddy bear is not stuffing, but a living, breathing human. A prisoner of a heinous charade. Early 2000s, Savannah. Martha and Eugene Grimes, a couple revered for fostering children and aiding the needy, harbored dark secrets in their sprawling Victorian home. Guests seeking refuge were sedated by the Grimes and forcibly stitched into animal costumes, turned into unwilling performers for a perverse entertainment. The Grimes' grotesque charade continued undetected for 18 years, the truth hidden by the couple's veneer of generosity and community spirit. The horrors were unearthed in 2022 when a former foster child, triggered by the game Five Nights at Freddy's, recalled the trauma, leading to a shocking investigation. As the investigation deepened, authorities uncovered a mass grave on the property's outskirts. Amidst the overgrowth, many victims were found, still grotesquely bound within their costume prisons.
How you know you ain't supposed to be spitting out that window?
Bag the fuck back. It's too damn early to be doing that
exactly.
Shit.
Exactly, and you cussing.
I don't give a fuck. You bag
loud.
The hell
you
back.
You loud, man. I'm just telling you.
There you go.
There you go. There you go with the shirt that sleeves touch the thumb.
How many times am I going to tell you? Don't touch me again. Bag the hell back and get that damn camera out of my face. Quit touching me.
Your sleeves aren't supposed to be wet, covering your elbows, man.
I don't give a fuck where my
sleeves supposed to
be. My sleeves,
where they at? It's
comfortable.
Mind your damn business. It's
comfortable like that? Shit. It's comfortable like you're that? Damn right, that's why I'm wearing it. Get that damn camera on
my face. Can I get a drip check? Drip fuck. Check?
Drip that, motherfucker.
It's long to it.
Get the hell out. Move.
All right.
About the second tower coming down.
I don't want to.
It's funny. Say a thing about the 13th Amendment then.
No.
Do you even care about me?
I don't want to say that.
You see that old lady over there?
Yeah.
Go throw up on her.
What?
Finish your chicken bake, then go throw up on her, okay? Do you want to sleep on a mattress again? That's or do you fine. Like being in the dark days? Okay, then go throw up on her.
Yes, sir.
Do you even care about me?
ใครจะไปรู้ว่าหมัดเนี้ยแม่งแรง
จริงจริงก็ผมบอกพี่แล้วว่าอย่าพี่ก็ไม่ฟังผมไงต้องให้แบบผมก็เป็นห่วงเนี่ยไม่อยากจะแบบทำอะไรพี่เยอะหรอกใช่ไหมเราก็พี่น้องกันผมก็แบบแค่แบบซอฟๆป่ะพี่เดี๋ยวผมพาไปหาหมอแล้วครับพี
่ไปผมแบบผมแ
ค่ครู
Bro, what the fuck? This nigga just... Hey, güey, Dios está contigo, güey.
Ahorita, güey, nomás fui a comprar, güey.
Bro, this nigga got God on his side, bro. This nigga just got shot.
No, vas a ver?
No, güey, ¿por qué no quiero?
My bad. We're leaving.
How are you living? I'm fucking.
Still want 25 for it?
Just out here at McDonald's trying to share the Book of Mormon with people.
This ain't Texas. Woo! Ain't no hold 'em. Hey! So lay our cards down, 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 down. So pocket lay.
How you doing, man?
Hey.
My name's Trevor. I'm with the Bail Bond Company. I need to talk to Antoine.
Girl Scouts?
Bail Bond Company. I need to talk to Antoine.
Shit. My bad. One more time.
My name is Trevor.
Okay.
I'm with the Bail Bond Company. I need to speak with Antoine. I have a warrant for him.
My name is not Antoine.
All right. You don't look anything like Antoine. What's your name, sir?
My name?
Uh-huh.
My name is Philip.
Your name is Philip.
Yeah.
Okay, Philip, do you have an ID with you?
No, Philip. But I'm not interested in anything you guys have to sell.
Uh-huh.
But I think you guys have the wrong address.
Okay, we definitely don't have the wrong address.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm 100% sure.
You want to double check?
No, I'm 100% sure.
Yeah, I think you got the wrong address.
No. Do you have an ID with you just so I can mark down who we talked to?
No.
No?
My name's not Antoine, though.
You said yourself
I don't look anything like Antoine. I think you
Are we going to play these kind of games?
What game?
Here's the deal. I know Antoine's here. Okay. So the best bet is you say, hey, why don't you come on in, take a look around, see that he's not here, and then we leave.
See, I have some personal belongings in the house. I don't feel comfortable with you searching.
Uh-huh.
But obviously I'm not Antoine.
Great. What's your last name, Philip?
Blake.
Philip Blake.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah, you got the wrong house, my friend.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, maybe the next door neighbor right there.
Right.
What address you got on there? You got to read the numbers.
2649. That's where you live, huh?
Maybe your paperwork's
right.
Wrong?
No, it's not wrong.
I think it's wrong.
I'll be right back with you.
All right.
What's up?
This guy's a complete pain in my dick.
Yeah?
He wants to play the runaround game.
Okay.
I'm going to try to invite him out. Okay. If he could get the drone right over my shoulder.
What's that mean? Yes or no?
No.
You just look like you're ready to get down with him, bro.
Now, yeah, I'm irritated already.
Okay.
With not Philip Blake. Thanks. I just don't want to trip through
it. Watch these windows, Tom.
Yeah. I've been watching the windows, but you can't really see in them. How you doing, not Philip Blake?
Welcome to the Crusty Crab. How can I help you?
Yeah, it's great. Hey,
Yes.
The bullshit name you gave me was really cute.
Thank you.
Okay. Do you want to give me your real name?
I already told you, Philip Blake.
Your name is not Philip Blake.
Why are you here again?
We're here for Antoine. Come here, I'll show you the one.
Antoine's Donuts?
Just walk over here.
I think Antoine's Donut Shop.
Yeah.
I think it's down the street.
Okay, well, can you do me a favor? Just come outside with me for a second.
I'm okay. All right? I'm going to stay inside.
Just walk over here with me for a second.
I'm good.
You really like to push buttons for a living, don't you?
Not really my thing.
No?
No, I can't.
Okay.
I can't push buttons.
So here's the deal. I'm going to come in, and I'm going to take a look around, and I'm going to verify that Antoine's not here.
Dangerous.